So, my lovely students, good morning. Let's start with part 6, chapter 8, class 8 and subject maths. So, you can find the formula of simple interest here, that is PRT upon 100. Now, when you go to bank, you might have heard the word interest. So, simple interest is always count on the principal. But compound interest is also count on the principal plus interest. So, generally, you get more interest with the compound interest. Let's figure it out. And the amount, that is the final price that you will be receiving, is your original money principal plus simple interest. Okay. So here P is principal, that is the original amount that you deposit in the bank. R is rate of interest, at what rate of interest the bank is giving you interest. And T is the time period, that for how many years you want to keep that money for the simple interest. So first is find simple interest when principal is 8,000. So someone is depositing some 8,000 rupees at 6% rate of interest and for 3 years, right? So what I'll do is, first of all, I'll make a line here. Even you do that in examination. First of all, principal. Extract all the values. You have to find rate of interest is 6%. Time is 3 years. And you need to find simple interest, question mark. And the amount, question mark, right? Okay. So first of all, let's put the formula. First step, simple interest is equals to PRT upon 100, right? So PRT upon 100, here P is 8,000, rate of interest is 6, T is 3, upon 100. Two zeros got cancelled. So what I have left with, 80 into 6 into 3. So 6 threes are 18, 80 into 18. What I'll do is, 18 eights are, I'll do 18 eights are. So it is 144. 144, right? Correct. And 10 I need to put here. So this is my simple interest that bank is going to offer me. But I have already deposited something. So my amount should be P plus SI. So what is P plus SI? What do you mean by P plus SI? That is principal plus simple interest is 1440. So imagine I am getting 8000 plus the simple interest, which is 1440. That is 0449. So I'll receive the amount as 944 rupees. So this is simple interest, right? Now if they ask, they have given you simple interest and they say find P, find R, find T. So you just make them subject. Suppose they have given you all of them and not rate of interest. So make rate of interest a subject and all the values you put, and you will find the different values, right? They can find you the different values, okay? So I'll show you the interconversions as well. Suppose if you want to find T, so make a T subject. So T is equals to what it will be, SI into 100 upon, now what is left, P into R, right? Suppose you need to find a P, principal, then SI, that is simple interest, into 100. SI into 100. Now P you are supposed to find, so R and T must be given, right? If you want to find R, then SI into 100 upon P into T, right? So just whatever value is missing, suppose T is missing, time is missing, you need to find time, so make T as a subject. If principal is missing and SI is given, RT is given, so make P as a subject. And if everything else is given and rate of interest they have not given, you need to find rate of interest, then make rate of interest as a subject. I hope you have understood this. We'll continue with the compound interest in the coming video. Please practice more and more examples of simple interest. Just remember the formula and you can solve all.